soil organic matter, which has got its own properties. For example, binding properties, like cementing properties, which other things do not have. Organic manures increase the activity of other micrograms that are useful there. Organic manures improve, they regulate the chemical properties and the other physical properties. What do I mean? When every soil has got its own properties. For example, you saw that hole there. When you look at that hole, it's as if you have an arrangement of layers of soil from top to bottom. That is a profile. But also in there, each type of soil, some soils are like a lot of sand, some soils are like a lot of clay. Now, when you apply manure, they have the ability to modify that type of soil. Meaning that no matter what type of land you have, you can actually modify your own soil. So the use of organic matter is absolutely very, very important. But what is the limitation with organic matter? What these organic fertilizers? These organic fertilizers do not release a lot of nutrients. They have the nutrients, but they cannot provide as much. They will give you, but not enough. Moreover, these ones that they have, they are those that are used very, very easily. For example, potassium, which is used in fruits, is easily taken because it is can be available in cells. However, there is nitrogen, which is useful for the leaves. There is phosphorus, which is useful for the roots. And then you have magnesium, which is useful for the leaf, for the chlorophyll, and so on. And then calcium, which is supposed to be available in the soil. They need your manure to first decompose very well. So one of the limitations of manure is that many farmers are not able to handle their manures very well. Look at these forms of manure, the three of them. One of them, this one was brought a year ago. You notice that it has almost turned to soil. That means the value of this manure is less than this one which was got 3 months ago. And it is also less than the other one which was brought a month ago. That means that you must handle your manure very well. Once you receive the manure, you must keep it under shade. There are also some manures, because the manures actually have their own composition. There are certain manures, for example, what we call deep litter or kalimbwe from the houses of chicken. They have got elements that are easy to lose and disappear into the air. They have got a lot of nitrogen, which is easy to disappear into the air. So each time a person brings manure and pours it there, kalimbwe, you should use it immediately. Do not bring it and put it under in some place and take months or take days without it. You will be perfuming the whole village. Actually, you just need like 1 week and the whole village will be perfumed, and for you, you go proud, you got manure. What actually happens is that you're going to lose it there. The moment temperatures go above room temperature, 27 degrees above, they begin to turn and disappear in the air. The moment it rains a lot, the nutrients begin to percolate, to disappear, to leach down below the layers, and it is not easy to catch all of them. So how you handle it is the problem with them. Number two, because they release little nutrients at a time, that means that you need large quantities, all of them, to provide for you manure. Take an example. You will need like 10 truckloads of, what is this Diana truck called? Elf. You need like 10 to 12 truckloads of elf. At about between 100 and 150 for you to supply manure to begin with as best of fertilizer which you begin with in the soil. That is quite a lot of money. Supposing you have 5 acres, that is quite a lot. So you've got to be very careful, given that the type you have bought might not be very good type. So that's one. Because you need it in large quantities, that means that there's going to be the cost of transportation going very high. And because that cost is high, you are likely to make losses if you are not careful. So that's about this other one. On the other hand, we have the second type of fertilizer. These fertilizers are called mineral fertilizers. The mineral fertilizers are the fertilizers which are prepared from factories. They actually have concentrated amounts. They have concentrated amounts of the nutrients that the plant calculated for the plant, that the plant requires for it to grow. It means that you must have, one of the limitations is that you must have a prior knowledge of how much you need to apply in a particular place. Number two, one thing about this fertilizers is that many people believe that they are very expensive. Actually, when you compute them at a time, and finally they become cheaper. What does that mean? It means that a synchronized, a well-calculated use of both of these could save you money. How do you do it? It means that a farmer, because now you're not every farmer will be able, to apply two basins at a go. But doesn't mean that a farmer who cannot apply two basins at a go should not grow bananas. Some farmers are able to afford one basin. Some farmers are able to afford half a basin. You should be able to take care of all these farmers there. So they already computed rates on average, for example, in Western Uganda. There are already new rates that are computed, for example. Now, these fertilizers that are called mineral fertilizers are best applied as supplements, meaning that you are adding to the what the other ones could not supply, but in computed, well-computed rates, and you will apply it in the other one. One combination that I can give you, for example, is if you are going to be using, you are unable to use two basins, you can then use just one basin, and you have this one, which is called urea. You have only 25 grams, and you could also have, for example, you could have this one as 95 grams. But you could also have a combination of half a basin and then 125 grams. Now, you are going to ask me, how is the farmer going to measure out these things? We've already been able to calibrate this. The farmers have this. They can use these bottles. That you see this calibration. If you cut it at around this point here, you're getting 25 grams. If you cut it at this point here, you're going to get 95. And if you cut it at this point here, you're going to get it at what? You're going to get it at 125 grams. But that's very, very important. What are the limitations with this? I said the first limitation is that you must have an idea how much of this you're going to apply there. And then two, the problem is sometimes you have an importer who is not ready, and then get supplying them regularly can also be a problem. Some people overinflate them. Then there are chances that you can get a person who is not supplying you the right material. Otherwise, about this is about the soil health. So we are saying that for your soil to be healthy, you must have nutrients that are enough. But on the other hand, I say the second thing you need is water. Even if somebody gave you meat and is not giving you water, you could have problems. You need to combine the use of water with the use of fertilizers. But before I leave fertilizers, all fertilizers have got principles to which from which they are used. The four principles follow what is called the four R's. What is the four R's? First, you must have the right fertilizer. That is the biggest problem we have. People are applying fertilizers and they are using the wrong fertilizer. The second is you must have the fertilizer applied at the right timing. What does the right timing mean? That you must apply a fertilizer at the time when it is required. Let us go back to planting of our hole. I said